गुड इवनिंग एंड आई माई सेल्फ अरिजीत कुमार नायक, आई एम विद अनुमिता बोशक फ्रॉम CSEA एंड वी हैव डेवलप्ड अ गेम ऑफ टिक टैक टो यूजिंग पाइथन एंड इट्स अ स्मॉल प्रोजेक्ट वी हैव डेवलप्ड विद इन फ्यू डेज एंड नॉट वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स. जनरली एज वी नो टिक टैक टो इज अ पेपर एंड पेंसिल गेम विच इज मेड फॉर टू प्लेयर्स एंड वी हैव टू प्लेयर्स एक्स एंड ओ. ईच वन टेक्स टर्न्स वन बाई वन एंड देर इज अ 3x3 ग्रिड. And like this, there is a 3x3 grid, and the player who succeeds making three moves in either in the horizontally, vertically, or diagonally, he or she is the winner. So it's a generally a paper and pencil game, but we have developed a virtual or digital version of the same tic-tac-toe using Python environment. So here is the how does it work? There is a game between, if we play the game, it is between the player and the computer. So first the board is printed. How does the board look? It looks like this. There are 9 spaces in between and we have to make our move choosing from the positions from 1 to 9. So the player first the player is asked to make his or her move, and as he makes his move, then computer on its own makes its move, and then after the computer makes its move, the board is printed with the new moves that the player and the computer made, and this process continues until one of the person wins, either the computer or the player. And if there is a tie that is deuced, the message is shown that the match is tied and no one has won. And if the player in between makes a wrong move, suppose we already have a X here and the player is trying to make his move in the fifth position and it is already filled, then an error will be shown that it is an invalid or wrong move. And then the message is also printed whenever you either lose or win, a message is printed, and then the game ends and you can play it once again. This was the working diagram. So now I will like to ask Anumita to continue the rest.
Thank you, Arijit, to giving me an opportunity to talk. So now we are going to discuss about the modules and the functions. Basically, a module in Python allows us to logically organize our code. Grouping related code into a module makes the code easier to understand and use. Basically, a module is a Python object with arbitrarily named attributes that we can bind and reference. And in Python, a function is a group of related statements or a block of code that performs a specific task. Next slide, please. So let's see which modules and functions we have used in our game tic-tac-toe. Firstly, we have used the module random module. Python has a built-in module that is random module, which implements pseudo-random number generators for various distributions, including integer, float, etc. We have also used sys module, which provides functions and variables used to manipulate different parts of the Python runtime environment. Now comes the functions. Printboard function is a user-defined function which prints the 3x3 board of the game. SelectCal function checks the function randomly allocates the characters like X or O to the players. Like sometimes the player is allocated the character X and the same time the computer is given the character O and vice versa. Now, canMove function checks whether the player or the computer is able to play the move or not. CanWin function checks that if anyone of the players has won the game or not. MakeMove function, it particularly makes the move for the player when it's his or her turn. Now comes the computer move function. From the name of the function computer move, we can understand that this function makes the move only for the computer when it's computer's turn. And lastly, we have used the space exist function, and the function checks whether there is any space left in the game board. Now we are gonna see that how the game is actually played. Here we can see the player and the computer is given the characters O and X respectively, and now the game starts. First the player I mean, we have make a move to from 1 to 9. The computer has also made its turn. Again, we have given our turn 8. And again, the computer has given its turn. So the game goes on. And lastly, we can see the result is that we lost the game. Basically, it's a tricky game. And it actually depends on you, that how you make your move so that you can win the game. Next slide, please.
So here we have two questions for our viewers. First, is indentation really required in Python or not? Generally, we don't necessarily require indentation in every programming language, but for Python, indentation is very much necessary, because in Python, it will not execute the code accurately and it will throw errors if the indentation is not done, as we don't generally use curly braces or any of the braces in our code in Python.
And the next question is, what is the usage of help and dir function in Python? Here, the both functions help and dir are accessible from the Python interpreter, and they are also used for viewing a consolidated, means combined or a united dump of built-in functions. So what does the help function does? The help function is basically used to display the documentation stream. And it also facilitates us to see the help related, like help related to modules, keywords, attributes, etc. And the dir function is mainly used to display the defined symbols.
Thank you very much, sir. This is our presentation for the game. And if you ask, we can show you the code as well. We have the code ready here.
Yeah, thank you very much. You show the code just briefly. Just show what the code portion does.
Yes, sir. So we have imported the modules random and sys here, and we have made a few variables as required and lists also. So here is the print board function defined, and it generally prints the board in which we play. There is a for loop, and then select char means it randomly allocates the use player and the computer a character for each one of them using the random function. And then can move, it checks whether the player can make the move or not, and if it can't, then it returns the either true or false. And can win function, it checks whether there is any winner or not, either horizontally, vertically or diagonally. Then there is a make move function, it makes the move for the player only. You can see here, it makes the move for the player only. So it does the move for the player. And then next, the AI, that is the computer, that on itself makes the move, and it is randomly made using its artificial intelligence. So as you can see, here is the complete code. If we ask for, we can explain it for briefly. And then there is the space exit. It generally checks whether the board is completely filled with X and O's or not. And if it is not, then the while loop continues and the game continues, and till it is completely filled with X and O's, the board is completely filled with X and O's, the game continues. So you can see here, while space exists, and if there is a tie, this message is printed, and if there is an invalid move, then the invalid number try again message is printed, and if we win, then a congratulation message is printed, and if we lose, then a message is printed as well.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for all this. Thank you.